So let me quickly show you guys how you can add an extra button after add to cart, which is like this button for me, and you could add any URL in that one. So if I click on this one, it takes me to the live demo page of this template that I've made, and then I can simply go back, and then all of these things are added automatically. So you could see, and the best part about it is that you don't always need to have this button. You could always choose whether to show this button on specific product or not. So let's quickly get started. So we are going to actually use this code, and again, I'm also not someone who is like crazy understanding of code of PHP. So I use like lots of ChatGPT and stuff to actually make this code, and I actually know how to change it now. So let me quickly show you guys. So the first thing that you need to do is go to add new plugins, and you actually need to install two plugins, or actually just one plugin based on how you want to add this. For example, you will need to have this one for fix, that is advanced custom field. Even though it says advanced, it's not advanced, it's just normal, but you could actually just activate this one. And the second one that we have is the second one that I'm using is called code snippets. Now whether you use the PHP in a child theme or whether you use in a code snippet, it's your choice. I would definitely prefer you to use it on code snippet, because it just allows you to like quickly, for this one, WP code, insert headers and footers, custom code snippet, this plugin. It's actually a pretty good one. And if I go into code snippets right now like this, you would see I can simply disable and enable it instead of actually going and removing it on in the text format. So that way you don't have to worry about breaking stuff and all. So the first thing that we need to do is go into ACF. After installing advanced custom field, go into field groups and click add new. And the first thing that I'm going to add is a true false. So let me search for it. So here it is, true false, and I'm going to call this. So for this one, I have called enable custom button, but you could add anything. For this one, I'm calling enable custom button. It will automatically add. You could also change this, and I've actually color coded it, so you could actually just name anything around there, and in this ping section make sure it is the same. So I'll quickly just go on the ACF first so that it is not confusing. It also add a text, so it will just show like add, do you want to show the custom button or not. Then let's close this, and here click another add field. This one I'll add a URL field. You could also add text field. Both of this work, but I'll go URL. Here we will type custom URL. Again, you could type anything else. For example, if I just show you guys my the second one, my live demo one, I have actually typed enable live demo, and here I have typed a live demo URL. But you will need to do changes accordingly, and I'll show you how to do it. It's pretty easy. You just need to replace whatever you have typed here with this code values. So once you have actually added URL, I will add a conditional logic. I'll click on this, and then I'll choose enable custom button only if it is checked. Actually, you don't need to like choose anything. It just says that if show this field, so we will only show this URL field if the enable custom button, which is this one, is actually checked. Or if you don't want to do like a check, or if you only want to show it when it is unchecked, you could do this, but we actually want to show it when it is checked. And you will quickly understand it what I mean. And here we will go on post type and then choose products. So when it will only be shown on post types, which are products. So for WooCommerce products, and let's call this custom URL button, something like this. Let's save it. Once it is saved, if I go into my product section in my WooCommerce products, if I let's say click on my latest products, for example, I have templates and I just add like lots of different stuff on my site just to give for free. You could see there is another section called custom URL button, and you could also like make where you want to show it by just dragging it out. And when you click on it, it just shows like another field. You'd see. So for now, I'll just add a link to, I guess I'll just add a link to my blog, a random blog page. So I'll link it to like how we can create this glowing effect on Elementor. So you could see. And in this product section, custom URL, I'll paste it and just update. But one thing that you're going to see is that it's not going to be actually showing around here. There is no button around here because we need to add it via our code snippet. So in here, I'll click add new. I will give this in description. So basically copy this one. Add your custom code. This is like my custom button. Choose this as PHP. And I'll add this like this. Click active and save it. You see it is running everywhere, any device type and everything you could choose. Now if I actually reload this page, you could see that I actually have a button here which is added, but it is not customized. But if I click on it, you could see it actually takes me to that page. Now, before we start customizing this, I need to show you how this works. So let me just show you what we are doing. So basically I have color coded it so that you should know that wherever I have set custom URL, if you type your own URL, for example, in the feed group, if you type something else around here. So for example, you typed like live demo URL and you type live demo URL here, then you will need to type your live demo URL, live demo URL, live demo URL. These two are something that you could add anything. It's just a function name. So basically we are making a function around here and then we are adding it after WooCommerce add to cart button. So make sure these two are same and you could name it anything. Next is enable custom button, and what we are doing is basically checking if it's a WooCommerce product and the ACF field is checked. So if it is a WooCommerce product and if the enable button is checked, then we will get the URL. So basically whatever you have added around here will need to be added around here because this is the check field. You see true or false. So basically copy this around this section and copy the second one in the green section, in this section. And now around here you could add anything. Basically we are adding a class so that we can customize it with CSS, and this is the text that is shown in the button. So for example, if I go into this one, you could see the custom button text. So this text is actually shown around here. So you could type anything around here. And if you don't want to have this icon, you could basically remove from this part to the right part this much. And you could also add any other font awesome icon, font awesome fire icon with this I class. That's all this code is doing. Now just let's quickly customize it. So for this one, I'll go into customize. Now if you check around here, we have added a class equal to button and custom URL button. Whichever you typed here, we will use that to actually target our button. So if I go into my custom CSS, it's not loaded, so waiting for it. If I go into my custom CSS and then I type, so I have used dot custom URL button, so I'll type dot custom URL button so that we are targeting the right button. And then anything you want to do on custom CSS, you could do it. You could also use ChatGPT and say that, hey, I have this button, just make this one have this background color, that background color in ChatGPT, and it will actually do it. So let me quickly show you how you could do ChatGPT and then how we can do it by ourselves. Customize this button to have transparent background, and on hover it should have have black background, make font size to 15 and make font to outfit. What else? Add a border of 2 pixels with black color and on hover. Wait, okay. Yep, add a background with black color. Let's see how it does, and I'll show you how we can do it manually too. So basically we use ChatGPT to do the coding for us. You could do it yourself too. I'll also show you how we can do it ourselves. Then you could see this is how it turned. For example, I'll need to change the color. So the text color should be FFF so that it's white. The border radius, we don't have a border radius. So I'll have to add a border radius like this of 10 pixels. Now again, you could use ChatGPT to do lots of the coding, but I'll use the one that I had already made, and I'll give it in the description. So let me just copy paste it. And then basically what we need to change is this one. So it was called custom URL button, and this one also we will call it custom URL button. And you could see this is how it looks right now, and you could see that it is not working perfectly for me because it is getting overridden by my theme. So basically what we need to do is add an important tag like this to actually change it to whatever I wish it to be. So if I do like black, we'll change it to black. If I do red, it will change it to red. So for this one, I'll add transparent. I'll add the color to be black, so 000. If anything doesn't work, just add this thing called important. Padding we can add to change the size of it, but before that I'll add a border of 2 pixel solid and black like this. So you could see border radius is not working, so I'll add an important tag and it will work. So like padding, and then for the top part I'll add a margin called top 10 pixels and then semicolon, and then you could see it is now adding. We can then align it in the middle. We can do all of the CSS that we want to actually make it work however you wish to. So you could see how this works. Basically just change whatever you want with CSS and just use ChatGPT if you wish to. And wherever it doesn't work, just add important tag. Pretty easy, pretty quick.